Manhattan, Kansas at KSU Stadium. These fans are raring to go. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Kansas State is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Gets out to around the 38. And he has a huge run.
I'll tell you right now, this guy is arguably one of the fastest players in college football today. There you see him turn it upfield with such fluidity and quickness.
It's caught, first down, and he's out of bounds.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Very good tackle in space. Broke away from one. And down he goes at about the 33-yard line. So with that run, they pick up another first.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Tackled after a decent run up the gut. Taken down at the 25-yard line. Third and two coming up here. Ball on the 25. A little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call. It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
Inside give, and he's taken down at the 19-yard line. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at the 13. Horn gained 6 yards with a short completion. Down, Sooners. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 9-play, 81-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. McGee is lined up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield.
The Sooners had one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to return.
The Wildcats know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much. We could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced that you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. That's a loss of 4 yards.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
It's third and 14. Ball on the 21.
innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
The Sooners' quarterback taken off earlier, down on the sideline right now. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we'll see him back in the game before the day is over. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. He's tackled at the 32-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Down around the 33-yard line.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
They've looked good so far on third down in this drive. Let's see what happens here.
Mike 20.
Now he's scrambling. He lost the ball. Comes in and scoops up the fumble. What do you think about that last turnover, Kirk?
Way to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Oh, and he had some steam on that throw. Oklahoma is up 7. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47. Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line. Receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 32. And now he's got room to run, and they get nice yardage on that run. It in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 22-yard line. Over the middle to his tailback. And down he goes around the 15-yard line. So at the end of one quarter, The Sooners lead 7-0. Back to the action now here in the second quarter.
Keep 15.
Oklahoma up 7 points. They'll knock him down for a loss.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
Third down again.
Come on, D.
Gets it out quickly. He's taken down at the 13-yard line. Makes the catch, but just not enough for the first.
Yeah, they're going to come up a little bit short here. Nice job by the defense of preventing this completion from turning into a first down.
Five wide. Caught, open field, and he is drilled at the 4. In the shotgun and 5 wideouts. Quick strike to the receiver, touchdown. Nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, as good as this defense has looked, I'm not necessarily surprised by this shutout. I mean, you and I were there on Wednesday watching this team practice, and when this first-team defense goes against their own first-team offense in a practice, sometimes it's actually better than the game itself. So they prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
He goes downtown, and it's caught. And he's taken down at the 25.
I think this defense right now doesn't realize if it's going to be a run or a pass, and that's the perfect time to be able to call play action. This defense is on its heels. They're guessing with the offense. That time they guess wrong, and the result is a big play for the offense.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. He's under pressure, and he's level at the 27-yard line.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
From the 27-yard line, it's second down. Bring him down behind the line.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, looks long enough, and he got it.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
14-3, Oklahoma. Kansas State kicked this one off. He just drills this one. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Slings it, and he hits him hard at the 27. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked.
The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Throws it to the halfback on the screen. Good tackle there in space. Complete, and he shoved out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, check back, six.
Right, check, line 80. Fire, wide, fire, 80.
Tackled for a loss. Third down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 39. He fights forward to about the 40. Richardson is waiting for the snap. Booming kick. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
The Wildcats know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
He's at midfield. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown. Big play.
I can guarantee you'll be seeing that one in the highlight reels. What a great, great run. A real display of all the tools that he brings to the table.
And he tacks on the extra point. Pennington looks ready to kick this one off. And he got all this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Oklahoma holds a four-point lead.
Passes left, going the other way. At the 30, to the 20. And he tackles him hard at the 16.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From the 16-yard line, first down.
Three down. Mike 22, he's coming, 22, he's going. Mike.
The 10. Nice run there. He's got himself a 100-yard rushing performance.
The game plan they devised has been working fantastically, and nowhere has that been more evident than in the rushing numbers.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Executed. He looked totally in control on that keeper.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point.
And he hits the PAT. with a three-play, 15-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So the score now, 17-14. Kansas State is lining up to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
This quarterback can make good passes. He just needs to focus on not forcing the ball to his receivers.
He wants it all. Tackle made at the 17. They really got beat by the deep pass.
Against man-to-man coverage like that, it's just a foot race.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Around 5 yards there on the option keep. The Sooners call a timeout. That's their second of the half. What a play, and that is first and goal. He's scrambling. Tackle at the 2 yard line.
200 jack! 200 jack! Motion,
motion. You know, at that point, I think grab the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
That is tight end touchdown. So the booth is trying to determine exactly where they'll spot the ball. So they're going to try and determine exactly where the ball was when he went down. So they review it, but there's just not enough evidence to overturn this one. Oklahoma is up by 3. And he converts the extra point. McGee has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He sends this one deep. And they can forget about returning this one. Wildcats had the right game plan, I think, because this is what they do so well. The problem is the defense knew that, and they're playing better right now.
I think you have to give the defense all the credit in the world here in the first half. I mean, you know, granted, we're giving up some yards to this running back. He's making some plays. But for the most part, they're keeping this offense out of the end zone. And we'll find out. It's still a long way to go in this football game. But up to this point, this defense has held this offense, for the most part, in check.
From their own 23-yard line. Second down.
Mike 40, check, check, he's coming, he's coming.
Yeah.
Gets it out in a hurry. Well, we can catch our breath at halftime along with these two offenses. What a showing in the first half. The Sooners lead it by 4.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
You know who I feel sorry for in that first half?
Who?
The poor production assistant on SportsCenter, who's going to try to sift through all of those highlights and come out with the ones he's going to choose to try to make the SportsCenter top 10.
Da-da-dun, da-da-dun. No, there's definitely a lot to choose from, but that's what you like as a fan. I think the fans, they like that and enjoy that more than they like seeing great defense. They like seeing guys go up and make huge one-handed stabs and guys make big, long diving touchdown runs, and they like all that. So they like watching guys hurdle over guys. You see it all the time. So I think the kids know that too, and they're trying to do their best to always, you know, make a huge play, make a big explosive play, and put a little cherry on top of that play so then they can be maybe on one of those ESPN top plays.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He really got a hold of that kick.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And they push him out at the 43. First and 10, ball on their own 43. Bring him down at the 39. A lot of concern from his teammates with a guy down on the field. Yardage on that run. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47.
Two down. Hey, Mike 20.
Complete. He's got room. And down he goes at about the 49. Short yardage defense here.
Ready?
And that was a big stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut them down.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. So they're just about set to get the game going again. Oklahoma is up four.
Easy.
Looks to his receiver, first down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 36. Down at the 31. They try the right side. He's tackled at the 32.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
He's taken down around the 18-yard line. And he's tackled right away.
You better be afraid of me.
gets out to about the 6-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. The Wildcats running back down there on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like he's ready to go. Nice run, and he's brought down. Oklahoma is up by four. Somebody jumped early down there. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Second down and goal. 7 yards for the touchdown. Touchdown, OU. There. Great looking touchdown.
Once you get inside the 10-yard line, this halfback is automatic.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's to the 40, and they make the stop at about the 47-yard line.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
From their own 47-yard line, it's first down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. First down. And he's tackled at the 33.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
From the 24-yard line, first down. He gets out to about the 8. This is the 8th play of this drive. He makes it to the 6-yard line. That's 3 down and 1 to go. The Sooners in front by 11. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
26 Mike, 26 Mike. Kill, kill.
touchdown, Wildcats. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. And they won't get the two. A nice nine-play, 77-yard drive. And they'll come away with 6 points after failing on the two-point conversion.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game. And every possession is going to count from here on out. Tackle made at about the 33-yard line. Makes it to the 41. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle at the 49-yard line. To about the 41-yard line.
Here we go, let's bring it. Let's go, let's bring it. Let's bring it.
Check. Green nine, Thunder.
Up the middle for a nice game. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down right around the 30. Pass complete there for about 5 yards and a first down.
And still, this gunslinger hasn't missed a receiver yet on this drive.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 30. Nice run up the middle.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Fires that quickly, incomplete. They're going to try a long field goal here. It's up, and he nails the long field goal.
Yeah, he got some good leg behind it, and he kicked an accurate ball right between the goalposts.
31-23, Oklahoma. McGee ready to kick, and it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Tries to buy some time. And down he goes, around the 37-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 37. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Throws a bullet over the middle. Brought down at the 45-yard line. The middle. That's a great tackle at the 44. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. chucks it downfield. Missed him.
That has to be frustrating for him because as a wideout, you love every chance to go deep and do something big.
Gray is back awaiting the punt. Booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Quick pass, and he tackles him hard at the 37. That reception good for 7 yards.
That's a good completion. They didn't get the first down, but they picked up about 7 yards.
He makes it to the 35-yard line. Kansas State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Short yardage situation here. It's 3rd and 1. He fights forward to about the 33. And the tailback picks up the first down.
He's a reliable ball carrier, as he showed right there. He got the 2 yards they needed for a new set of downs.
Just under 2 to go in the game. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Second and 8. Ball on the 30-yard line. Inside the 10. Spectacular play, and now it's 1st and goal. Perfectly run option keeper.
Not what you'd expect when you prepare all week to defend the option. But then again, give this offense some credit. These guys aren't exactly the scout team.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. Brings up a 2nd and goal. 2 yards to the end zone. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. And this is the 8th play of the drive. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. 31-23, Oklahoma. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.